It is a sport where young girls are asked to grow up fast, to summon poise and elegance beyond their years. But oh, how we've seen them mature, becoming graceful champions. Their youthful achievements forever etched in ice.
We first saw her when she was 14 years old, and now she's 19 in the full flower of her championship form.
Hasn't she got a lot of moxie?
Good for her.
What a moment for this young lady.
Oh, so nice.
Just terrific.
Tonight, another young woman we've watched grow up stands on the verge of greatness.
Well, I think Michelle Kwan Raitt is probably one of the top three skaters in all of U.S. history.
You name people like Dorothy Hamill and Peggy Fleming and those, and you know, you have to put her name right in there with all those, the greatest skaters in the world.
It's a challenge to try to stay on top, to try to be number one.
3 years from now, in this very same place, her quest for Olympic gold will begin. But first, in this sport where much is asked of young women, Michelle Kwan must call upon her poise, her elegance. Will she earn her third national title and be celebrated as one of skating's all-time best? Salt Lake City, the capital of Utah, lit up and alive tonight. While an Olympic controversy has enveloped this community, the nation's finest figure skaters look to put that scandal on ice. And we welcome you to the Delta Center for the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. Earlier today in the men's competition, Michael Weiss captured his first U.S. men's title. And hi, everybody, I'm Terry Gannon. Later tonight, we'll have live coverage of the ladies' free skate, with Michelle Kwan trying to win her third gold medal against a field that includes a number of young guns who could be right back here in Salt Lake 3 years from now competing for an Olympic gold medal. And speaking of the Olympics, the largest scandal in the modern history of those games continues. Leslie Visser will have more later in our broadcast. Right now we turn our attention to the pairs free skate and welcome in Olympic champion Dick Button. It's going to take all of that Ivy League education to sort this one out.
Well, can you imagine a day, a daytime soap opera transformed into primetime sports television? Well, you know, that's what we've got here tonight. Kyoko Ina, one half of the pair in second place, was champion last year with Jason Dungeon. But she gave Jason the old heave-ho to skate with John Zimmerman. However, Jason is here as the coach of none other than the Hartzells, who are in the lead after the short program. Could this be sweet revenge? Ah, the plot thickens. And you know, Peggy Fleming knows that there are no clear favorites here.
Well, that's true, Dick. You know, the title is up for grabs. And for most people at home watching, it's hard to imagine spending every minute of your day with your brother or sister. But that's just what two of our top teams do. Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler and our leaders Danielle and Steve Hartzell have an advantage as brother and sister. They've been together since birth, and because of simple genetics, they also move the same way. To overtake the Hartzells, Kyoko and John, who have been together for only 8 months, will have to get in sync and rely on their individual experience.
And Peggy, here are the way things stand heading into the free skate. Danielle and Steve Hartzell trying to win their first gold medal. They're the leaders right now. Ina and Zimmerman in second place. Handy, Benabose trying to edge out Stiegler and Stiegler for the bronze medal here.
Representing the University of Delaware Figure Skating Club in Newark, Delaware, let's have a warm welcome now for Laura Handy and J. Paul Benabose.
And now taking the ice first, 18-year-old Laura Handy and 21-year-old J. Paul Benabose in third place.
Well, they are so surprised and thrilled to be in third place. I just hope nerves won't play a factor for them. They have a lot of energy. They're opening with a triple twist. nice height. Side or throw triple salchow. Oh, beautiful spring in the air. Nice tight turns, straight legs. And they're side by side, triple toe loops. Oh, very nice.
Off to a great start.
The music, Sleeping Beauty by Tchaikovsky, and Concerto for Orchestra and Violin, also by Tchaikovsky. They're an extremely well-matched pair. Both their ages, their physical structure, their skating abilities, are very good sync. A star lift, a one-armed star lift, and turn out and a drop down.
Nice and smooth on the exit.
Side-by-side double axles. And a throw, triple. She double-footed it, but she gets wonderful height, and she has lovely straight legs and completes her revolution before she lands the jump. It is not sneaked out revolution. A lightness to this pair and an elegance to them that even though they are very young and really not very experienced, it shows that they have rather wonderful potential.
Good unison on the side-by-side combination spin. They were turning right in sync.
This only their second trip to the Senior Nationals. They finished in sixth place a year ago, but they captured a silver medal at the Junior World Championships recently.
A little bit of a stumble there on his part, causing disruption in the flow of that spin. That plus the fact that in their side-by-side double axles, she did only a single axle will hurt them, but I wouldn't think a great deal. They left that lift out. It was to have been a one-arm helicopter lift. See, they're not back onto sync yet. They're losing. They've lost the excitement that they had at the beginning of the program.
I don't know if that's due to being exhausted or not good training habits, but they started out so well. They seem to be slowing down, making little mistakes.
And she's dropping into that in not a very good position. And a two-foot landing. I think there's something that's been very upsetting to them. Something's wrong. Something was wrong at the end. And I don't know what it was, but they just completely fell apart after a certain moment that about four or five elements back, it was not good.
But they got off to a terrific start with this throw, triple salchow. Look at the lift she gets, how straight she is in the air, and plenty of time to open up for that landing in a good position. The side-by-side triple toe loops, they were excellent. very difficult to do. The timing was good. They were right in sync. It was beautifully done.
The judges marks for Laura Handy and Jay Paul.
And now there'll be two sets of marks, of course, for technical merit and presentation. This free skate worth two-thirds of the overall score. First set, 5.2 to 5.7.
And certainly creditable marks. They're sitting there, by the way, with Ron Luddington, one of the icons of the field of ice, dancing and pair skating, and Tracy Politis. And they have a very interesting group of people who have put together this program, very much the Russian and classical influence.
The lower scores now for presentation, Dick, 4.9 up to 5.4 for Laura Handy and J. Paul Benevos after a great start. And when we come back, the team in second place, Yoko Ina and John Zimmerman, plenty of experience, but not together. For them, the biggest challenge comes from within.
Ourselves are definitely our toughest competition. We're not looking at other skaters thinking, oh, we have to beat them, or oh, watch out for them. Right now, we're still learning about what we can do, what our ability is, and we set goals for ourselves, and we say, okay, if we can get through 80% of the program and do that somewhat decently, we'll be happy.
Competing on behalf of the Skating Club of New York in New York City and the Birmingham Figure Skating Club in Birmingham, Alabama, a warm welcome now for Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman.
Welcome back to Salt Lake City. The pairs championship continues as Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman take the ice. They are in second place.
The music, Phantom of the Opera, Andrew Lloyd Webber.
I think each one of their competitions they participated in is a big lesson and a tool for them to find their strength as a pair.
They both admitted they had the jitters the other night in the short program.
And they are opening with side-by-side triple toe loops. Here they go. Oh, very nice.
Very solid. He has had difficulty with his triple jumps before. He seems to be conquering that problem. I've got to tell you, when you throw a gal into the air and twist her and she does a split in the middle of it and then try to set her down on that eighth of an inch wide blade, it isn't easy.
And that's that timing and rhythm that they need to connect with one another. They've only been together 8 months.
He's the one that's been having trouble technically. She's very strong from a technical point of view, but his drama and flair are outstanding.
That was a beautiful overhead lift. That was supposed to be a throw triple loop, and it ended up just being a double.
Sid spins. Very nice layout position.
Their coach, Tamara Masvina, knows that their styles and their rhythm are different, but she said she's going to work with them and use that contrast.
And says there is no rush. They're pointing towards this city, but the year 2002 and the Olympics.
Now here comes the throw triple salka that they planned. It was a double.
And that timing just wasn't there.
I'm quite sure that there's some problem here also, because they would not be backing off this, these moves, if everything was all right. That simple fall, I don't think, would have extended this long.
Nice extension in her upper body and her arm on that lift.
She's always had a great back. They seem to be more on track now than they were earlier.
This is a nice sequence. It really, I think, accentuates their styles so nicely.
An interesting progression through these programs. Both the earlier pair of Handy and Bina boys, and now Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, seem to have had disruptions in the program that just took away their energy. Tamara knows what's happened.
Tamara Moskovina, the famous Russian coach, also coach of the world champions, reigning Olympic champions, and there's John's family. That's Laura, and on the right is mom and dad. Got to be disappointing right now, though.
It was on. Now watch here as she toe picks, splits, beautiful position, the wonderful turning, but she's leaning quite far around. Now watch here as he sets her down. She sets her foot on his left foot, and that doesn't get it between his feet, and that causes the problem. Now look right here. Watch as she toe picks from between his feet. Now watch his left foot right there. She steps right in front of it, knocks them down, and they disappear. What a pity.
Kyoko Ina, the two-time and reigning champion of this event, although that was with her former partner Jason Dungeon, of course. Tonight has been much tougher.
There they are with Tamara Moskvina and her husband. And these marks are not what they expected. A markdown for that major fall, and I think somewhere along the line for the slowdown in the program, the lack of energy. That's reflected in this mark.
The presentation marks, Dick, 5.3 up to 5.7. And in terms of those that have skated in the free skate, Ina and Zimmerman, the leaders. But we're coming back with the brother-sister team of Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler in fourth place, trying to make a move on the podium. Welcome back to the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. A reminder, tomorrow beginning at 1:30 Eastern, 10:30 a.m. Pacific, Payne Weber College basketball, great regional action, Georgia Tech taking on Louisville, Texas Oklahoma State, or Temple Xavier. Then at 4 o'clock Eastern, following the basketball, it's the World All-Around Speed Skating Championships from Hamar, Norway. All tomorrow, right here on ABC Sports.
Ladies and gentlemen, Tiffany Stiegler and Johnny Stiegler.
She is only 15 years of age, and he just a year older. Tiffany and Johnny Stiegler, the brother-sister team, they are in fourth place with an opportunity to perhaps move to the podium.
The music, Giselle, Adolphe Adam. They work with Irina Rodnina and Elena Cherkaskaya, the great Russian. Irina Rodnina, the great Russian pair skating champion. And you can see the Russian influence already in their style.
Very dramatic facial expressions on Tiffany's part. She is an absolute doll. She really sells this team.
That's because it represents the opening scene, the mad scene. Oh, again.
They almost had the same trouble that Kyoko and John had. This throw, triple loop.
Oh,
beautiful. Wow.
Extraordinary height. That was just wonderful. The way, the height and the flow and the speed of that.
dangerous as all get out, but when it works, it is spectacular. And that was side by side, double axles.
Tiffany and Johnny with a terrific debut at the Nationals a year ago, finished in fourth place.
Look at this beautiful position in the air.
And the way she turns out her foot, stretched up in the star position.
Makes it look more extended, more pointed of the pointed toe.
And he singled his side-by-side loop.
Thing you have to remember, even though the U.S. can send three teams to the World Championships in pairs, the Stieglers cannot go because Tiffany did not turn 15 by July of last year.
That spiral position on her was first rate, as is this death spiral.
This position is so pretty in that pair, spin, arch in her back. They have some really fine moments in their program.
Throw triple salchow. It's again the lift and the height, the straight, stretched, tight legs. Their speed and stroking, their line and position. Something we see little of in the singles to this extent. Doesn't she remind you a bit of the very young Irina Rodnina? The very young Ekaterina Gordieva.
She has that magical face.
And also the same long-limbed look. He singled that side-by-side salchow.
Nice unison on this combination spin.
Very nice turned over position. Now, and this final forward inside death spiral. Watch her feet. Look at her feet, the stretch, the point of the toe. Very nice. She has beautiful legs.
This pair has such wonderful potential. They are just such a joy to watch.
Irina Rodnina, 10 times the world champion, 3 times Olympic champion with 2 different partners, a force and a source of Russian pair skating. There's John.
Linda and John, the Stieglers' parents, and Tiffany and Johnny from Manhattan Beach, California, the novice national champions, the junior national champions.
And now look at this throw. That, first of all, look in the loop position, back outside it. Now watch the height. Look at her legs, the stretch, the tightness of it. He throws her aggressively and gets slightly out of control, but that's part of the course.
Hi, Stephanie.
The judges marks for Tiffany Stieglers and Johnny Stieglers for
Tiffany and Johnny, along with Irina Rodnina on the right and Yelena Cherkovskaya. Right next to them, the first set of marks for technical merit.
And those are standard for the mistakes that they made.
They're a very young pair. They're still immature. They have wonderful potential, wonderful elegance and line. Thank you, Elena Cherkaskaya and Irina Rodnina.
And now for presentation 5.1 to 5.6, and it places them in third place in terms of those that have already skated tonight.
And I think that reflects some of the line and positions that they have.
And when we come back, the leaders after the short program, Danielle and Steve Hartzell, take the ice right after this message in a word from our ABC stations. And we welcome you back inside the Delta Center for a look at our mobile update of the current standings. Ina and Zimmerman in first place, Andy and Vinnebos in second, and Johnny and Tiffany Stiegler in third place.
Danielle Hartzell and Steve Hartzell.
But here are the leaders after the short program. It's their gold medal to win or lose. 18-year-old Danielle Hartzell and her 21-year-old brother Steve.
Music, Romeo and Juliet, Tchaikovsky, and later, Man in the Iron Mask.
And Danielle and Steve have worked very hard over this past year, and I do see a lot of improvement, but they still muscle a lot of their skating. They're very powerful, good height, good flow over that split triple twist. Trouble on those side-by-side triple toe loops.
But they were basically okay. You know, just they were completed. Even though there was a little struggle on the landings. Throw triple Salchow.
Nice.
And notice the difference between this and the previous pair of Stiegler and Stiegler. This is a far more solid technical performance.
And this is a move they invented, the heart attack lift. She practically does a handstand. Gives her parents a little heart attack on the side, too.
Side-by-side double axles. Very strong, very powerful.
I think she singled hers.
Danielle and Steve in a position where they have to win this free skate to unseat Ina and Zimmerman at the top. And don't forget Dick's soap opera, Jason Dungeon, one of the coaches for Danielle and Steve, the former partner of Kyoko Ina.
Note how similar they are, both in physical structure and type and style of skating.
Smooth transitions in this pair spin.
But they somehow have to yet develop in artistry and elegance. They have plenty of good attack. They are not timid.
Coming up a throw, triple loop. Nicely done.
Switching to a star lift.
They look very comfortable out there. They look like they're taking their time on each element.
Star lift.
final move, the back outside death spiral. What a performance. Good for them.
How great that was. They're such solid skaters. They have worked consistently, steadily. There's Jason Dungeon, his other coaches, Johnny Johns and Mitch Moyer in the background. A satisfying performance because they completed their technique. They did not go beyond themselves. And what a nice result for them.
Ina and Zimmerman, well, they got to wait and see if it's enough. I'm not so sure it is. They're in first place, the current leaders, but Danielle and Steve Hartzell will hear their marks. Did they capture the gold medal? We'll find out when we return. Welcome back to Salt Lake City. Make sure you're with us next Sunday at 1:30 Eastern, 3 Pacific here on ABC Sports. We'll have the Chevrolet Skating Spectacular. You'll see exciting exhibition performances from the men's, ladies, pairs, and dance medalists from the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships, including, of course, Michelle Kwan. And get the latest results of ABC's figure skating coverage on America Online. Keyword, ABC Sports. Danielle and Steve Hartzell waiting to find out if they have indeed won the gold medal.
And this was the wonderful throw triple Saukow that they did in the program. Good lift, good control. Not a whole lot of height in this, but very much in control and good speed in the landing.
They're not as elegant, they're not as graceful as some of the other pairs, but the steadiness of their technique as represented in this mark is just first rate.
They won a bronze medal last year. They won a junior world championship in 1997. Now the second set of marks for presentation.
5.6.
In a wide range, but those are good enough, Dick. Danielle and Steve Hartzell are the new U.S. pairs champions. They edge out Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman. Kyoko knows both sides of it. The two-time and until moments ago reigning U.S. champion along with Jason Dungeon. And now she'll settle for the silver medal. And there's Georgia Hartzell, Danielle and Steve's mother.
Those are happy tears.
This concludes the championship pairs competition. But stay with us now, because in just a few minutes, you'll be meeting...
So for the first time, Danielle and Steve Hartzell will stand on top of the podium wearing gold. Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman settle for the silver. And it's Laura Handy and J. Paul Benabo surprisingly capturing the bronze medal. That is a great U.S. national championship for them and the rest here in the pairs free skate. By the way, the last brother and sister team to win the U.S. title, Kitty and Peter Carruthers, back in 1984. Guess where it was? Right here in Salt Lake City. And they were inducted into the USFSA Hall of Fame this week here in town. Well, it's been a remarkable championship inside the Delta Center, but in Salt Lake City, the Olympic controversy continues. For more on that, let's join Leslie Visser.
Terry, when Salt Lake City decided to welcome the world in 2002, this is not the kind of advanced publicity the community anticipated. On Thursday, the organizing committee, badly bruised by scandal, named Mitt Romney its new CEO to help with the overhaul.
These games and the preparation leading up to these games will be held at the highest level of ethical conduct. There is no possible excuse for compromise of principle. There has never been a willingness to accept as an answer for failure. Everybody else does it.
The announcement, along with the restructuring of the board, came only days after an ethics panel announced that more than $1 million had been spent courting IOC members.
The Olympics have been tarnished. For us to think that it's not, our community's been tarnished. The only way we'll be able to alleviate that cloud is to put on the best games that there have ever been.
If almost everyone approves of Romney, not everyone agrees on the process. Zee Owen, an Olympic luge alternate in 1994, is outraged at her perception of the board's conduct.
It's not something that I wish to be associated with. I've set higher standards for myself as far as honesty, ethical behavior, and I personally don't want to compromise myself.
there could be even harsher judgments as investigations by the IOC and the Justice Department are completed. A special meeting of the 115 members of the IOC is scheduled for March, where those guilty of misconduct will be named and expelled. Terry?
When we come back, we will go live with the Ladies' Championship. Michelle Kwan, off to a great start, seeking her third U.S. title. But there are a couple of 13-year-old shooting stars right behind her. Sarah Hughes and Naomi Nari Nam. The ladies take the ice when we come back to Salt Lake City. They are 13-year-olds sharing an incredible fantasy. Sarah Hughes won last year's junior national crown. Naomi Nari Nam won the audience's hearts in the short program after a nasty spill. This is the night of their young lives. At the ripe old age of 18, Michelle Kwan has lived the dream they are chasing. She well remembers being an up-and-comer, but now she pursues only history. And she become the 12th woman to earn 3 national titles. A live look now at the largest crowd all week here at the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships. They've come to see the ladies free skate. It is already underway, the final group warming up on the ice. And here are the standings after the short program. Michelle Kwan in the lead ahead of one of the 13-year-olds, Sarah Hughes. Amber Corwin in third place. And then the youngest competitor here, Naomi Nari Nam, ahead of Aaron Pearl and Angela Nikodinov. And there is Michelle Kwan, the overwhelming favorite, trying to become a 3-time champion. And Peggy Fleming, you look at her program tonight, what can we look for?
Well, she's in a class by herself. She's taking this competition very seriously. You can see she's got 7 triples planned, including a triple toe, and we'll see if she includes it in her program. And you see there the Charlotte move. It's a move that was first done in the 1900s, and I'll talk about it later in her program.
Dick, how about Sarah Hughes? How does her program compare?
Well, let me tell you something. From an athletic point of view and a technical point of view, she's right up there. She, too, has 7 triples and a triple loop combination, which is harder than the double-triple combination that Michelle is doing. That's the combination that made Tara Lipinski famous just a year ago.
She's in second place. In third place is Amber Corwin. With all the talk of the 13-year-olds, she's kind of been out of the spotlight, but right in the thick of things. And great practices all week. Great in the short program. And then the youngest one, Naomi Nari Nam.
And she is a pistol, let me tell you. One thing to watch for with her is her split jump. It comes late in the program, and it is brilliant.
But make no mistake, Michelle Kwan, the favorite here. But skating is about more than just gold medals and titles for her. It's a chance to escape.
There are times when I'm in a bad mood. I put my skates on, I get out onto the ice, and suddenly I become happy. All my fears, all my sadness, everything is out of me. When I hear the music, it just takes me. I feel like I'm the instrument. The music is coming from within, and it's coming right through me, and my heart is in the palm of my hands, and I'm giving it to the audience and sharing all emotions that I have inside. There are times when I feel like the audience is with me. I make a mistake and I can hear them going, oh, and that's what I'm saying to myself when I'm skating and I fall and I go, oh. There are also times when I can hear them getting louder and louder until there's no music and they're still clapping. I feel like, why is this ending? Why has it come to an end? I wish it would last forever. It feels like you're flying. You feel free, you have room, you have so much space to work with. It's like saying to an artist, okay, you have this much paper to work on. You're limited. But when I'm skating, I feel like I have the whole ice as a canvas and something I can work with and something I can just
do whatever I want. And I like that freedom.
Trying to take her sport to a new level every time she takes the ice. And trying to become the first three-time ladies champion since Jill Trenary back in 1990. Well, here's the order in which they'll skate. Sarah Hughes is up first, maybe a good thing for a 13-year-old. She can't sit around and be nervous at all. Michelle Kwan second to take the ice, then Erin Pearl, Amber Corwin with a chance, remember, to make the world team. Most likely the top three finishers will go to Helsinki in the World Championships. Then Naomi Nari-Nam and Angela Nicodino.
Please leave the ice.
You know, these practice sessions tell you a lot. We've seen some falls by Naomi Nari-Nam. We saw a beautiful triple-triple combination from Michelle Kwan. And the nervousness of the young ladies really tells you where they're sitting at this particular moment. You can read a lot from a warm-up.
Well, Sarah Hughes has had a great time this week. She has done every interview. She's had nothing but smiles on her faces all week. But there's no way you can get to a moment like this with all the people in the house here and on television. There are her parents, Amy and John. John, a great athlete, too. He was an All-American hockey player back on the Cornell National Championship team back in 1970.
New York City. Would you please welcome now Sarah Hughes.
Swig of water. Last words of encouragement from her coach,
Robin Wagner.
And the 13-year-old from Great Neck, New York, takes the ice here in the ladies' free skate. The silver medalist from the Junior World Championships.
It's interesting that she's chosen the music, Swan Lake, Tchaikovsky.
Well, Sarah seems to be taking this competition in stride. She's been excited all week like any 13-year-old, but it hasn't overwhelmed her. And that's a key part of being a solid competitor. Her first jump is a double axle, and watch the good spring that she gets up in the air. Nice. Jump, triple Lutz, double toe. Oh. It's like she didn't go in with an attack kind of attitude. She did them nicely in the warm-up.
Sarah, the junior national champion from a year ago. This is her first try at the senior nationals.
Now coming up is her triple loop combination. Back outside takeoff. Oh, nice. Beautifully done.
That makes up for the triple Lutz fall. Layback that is quite attractive. And a catch spin. She has a delicate quality to her skating. There doesn't seem to be an extraordinary amount of tension, yet she pulls off very difficult athletic moves.
She looks very calm, very long-limbed skater.
These just need more tension in them, more stretch, more holding. Triple flip jump. Watch the turn, the pick.
Nice layback spin position. Good turnout of the foot and leg. Be a little faster. Now here comes another triple Lutz. She fell on earlier. That was much better.
And right to the beat of the music.
Nice smile on her face.
Triple toe loop. He's doing these with great ease. Falling leaf jump.
She just needs to work on all these steps in between, making every move important.
Remember, even though she is only 13 years old, she can go to the World Championships because she earned a medal at the Junior World event.
One more triple left in her program, a triple salchow. Here's her preparation. And inside edge takeoff. Nicely done. Good for her. She should be very proud of herself.
Her parents, John and Amy. Biggest applause coming from them. A large family, too. She's got five brothers and sisters. And she has had a ball this week here in Salt Lake City. Sarah Hughes will have her marks when we come back. And then Michelle Kwan will take the ice, trying to win her third title right after this from our ABC stations. Welcome back to Salt Lake City. Sarah Hughes along with her coach, Robin Wagner.
And this was a look at her triple Lutz double toe combination, which she ended up falling on. Didn't get quite the spring in the air and couldn't complete the revolution. And this was a spectacular triple loop, triple loop. Look at how equally high at the good lift in each one of those triples.
Sarah, who still lives at home, hasn't left for a training site. Now the first of two sets of marks for technical merit, 5.3 up to 5.6, the range.
Those are very creditable. She didn't have really marvelous spins in the sense that they were fast and tight, but everything was very good, generally, even, just right where you should be at 13.
And marks for presentation. Hard to believe she's still 13, isn't it?
She also is 5'3", and that's, you know, a good height for a young lady in this position.
Now, Michelle Kwan takes the ice. Remember the Nationals a year ago? Two of the greatest performances that anybody had ever seen at the Senior National. She received 15 perfect sixes for those performances. And here she is trying to win her third U.S. ladies title.
The music, incidentally, is by Jules Massenet. Notice the delicacy of her movements. Although she's strong and fast and powerful, everything is very light and easy.
The music has a lot of tension to it. They wanted something passionate and daring, and Michelle says this music takes you everywhere. Her opening jump, triple Lutz, double toe. Very solid, very easy and relaxed. And this is the new variation of the Charlotte move. Very effective. It was first done in the 1900s.
Charlotte Oehenschlagel performed it at the Hippodrome in New York in 1915, and she was an enormous success.
Yes, it's a very effective move. Even Sonia Henie did it. And now coming up is the triple toe combination. Let's see if she puts this in. Is warming up on it on the practice. First one, second one, very solid. Good height on both of them.
Now the thing that was really, really marvelous about that was how easy it was, how secure it was, the lightness of it. And a more difficult, one of the more difficult triple jumps, this loop. Again, easy, secure, completely in control.
And right with the music.
Since her silver medal at the Olympics, she has won every event in which she's entered, all nine of them.
Thank you.
double axel. Watch the forward edge. Triple salchow. From the back inside edge.
She is just making this look so effortless. Beautiful extension on this spiral. When Michelle was 13 years old, Lori Nickel, her choreographer, gave her one word to think about as she skated. It was ooze, like toothpaste coming out of a tube. She says she thinks of that to this day.
Well, thank heavens it doesn't look like toothpaste coming out of the tube. Was a very tight entrance into that. Did you notice how that cut sharply? And she wasn't quite around before she reached for it, before the toe pick pulled her up.
Yeah, it was almost like she rushed that jump.
Oh, that's an interesting. Almost anybody else can fall and you don't think twice about it.
Right.
When Michelle falls, it's like national news. Well, my bet is that the judges will simply give her a little nod, like a tenth of a point, and that she'll be in the 5.8s and 5.9s all across the board.
Well, this crowd couldn't care less about that fall. Even Michelle Kwan, the look on her face when it happened, she got up and looked at the crowd, smiled, as if to say, did that really happen?
It is raining teddy bears and flowers out here.
Well, you know, one of the things about a fall is how much it disrupts the program. It didn't. She bounced down, she bounced right up and kept on going.
And it might take a while to pick up all of these falls. That's a pretty good handle on Michelle there. Sarah Hughes watching her idol. She's been in awe of Michelle Kwan all week long. We'll have Michelle's marks, and then Aaron Pearl will take the ice here at the Delta Center next.
I mean, yeah, you shouldn't feel bad about it.
The Delta Center finally quiet, the ice finally clear after Michelle Kwan left the ice.
Now, look at this combination. Loop, triple toe loop, right here. Triple toe loop, land, triple toe loop. Now, that's easy, clean, and perfect. You can see Frank Carroll off in the back. But look here, watch the toe pick right there. See how it turns over? It was not straight. It was like the pole vault had suddenly twisted at the end. And watch right here. She's almost out, but not unhooked. Doesn't check it. The revolution continues, and she goes down. But it's not the kind of a fall that is truly disruptive of the program.
For technical merit.
So now the first set of marks.
5.9.
What did I tell you? 5.8s and 5.9s.
5.8.
It's the first time in my life I've ever called it right.
5.8. 5.8 and 5.9.
And we'll hear about it for some time.
Yeah.
And our marks for presentation.
And now the marks for presentation normally 5.9. Even higher. Let's see.
They 5.9. Are. 5.9s except for 1.258.
5.9.
Well, it's such a perfect package. I mean, she thinks of all the details in her program.
I think more than anything else, it's a satisfying program. I mean, it fills you with great satisfaction for the jumps and the spins and the style and the elegance and the musical interpretation and the charm of it. I mean, it's got everything going for it.
Clearly in a class by herself.
Thank you. Hugs for everybody. Oh.
From the Detroit Skating Club in Bloomfield Hills, Michigan, a warm Salt Lake welcome, please, for Aaron Pearl.
So here is Aaron Pearl, only 16 years of age, trains in Bloomfield Hills, Michigan, and was third at the Junior Nationals a year ago. This is her first trip to senior.
Well, she does have six triples planned in this program, but she has a very awkward jumping technique. Watch how she overcrosses her free leg in the jumps.
But she does have energy and she does have speed.
First jump, a double axel. See that free leg just swinging out.
It wraps around the skating leg.
The reason that's not good, watch here again in this jump. Again, the wrap.
Double toe, triple toe.
The reason that wrap is not good is, number one, it takes too much time to unwrap it, and secondly of all, it looks ugly. You see? It's a bad habit to get into, and a lot of very young skaters do, and once they get into it, it's very hard to get out of it.
Originally from Scarborough, Maine, she has moved with her mother to the Detroit area to train with Richard Callahan. She was injured this fall off the ice for a number of weeks with a stress fracture.
One of the things that's very easy to see about this lady is that she's a very good athlete. She has strong jumping ability, good spring.
Difficult combination, triple loop, double toe combination. She just did a double.
Those were both attractive positions in the spirals. I wish she'd held them longer so that you'd get a chance to see them. Again, that wide swinging free leg really almost knocks it off balance.
It makes her spin very slow in the air.
Well, let's give her due. In fifth place heading into this free skate, and how'd you like to be 16-year-old and following Michelle Kwan?
That's a tough act to follow.
Well, listen, don't obscure the fact that Erin is a very fine athlete and a very good skater. I think it's a matter of cleaning up some of the bad habits that have happened. But underneath it all, she is a very talented young lady.
And also in skating, it's the packaging, the music, the costume, the choreography, and that attention to detail that makes all the difference in the world.
This loop. This is almost a 4-minute point in her program, and she's still going with great speed.
And remember, we're up here in the altitude, so that is a factor for all the skaters.
It's taken its toll all week, yeah.
Good spring on that. I mean, that was marvelous.
But to make that a little better, if she would have stretched in her positions, it would have been a spectacular move. Good for her.
Well, I don't care if she skated after Michelle Kwan or not. She has nothing to be ashamed of.
Well, she held her own. That's very proud of what she did.
Proud and relieved at this point, yes. I think. Very happy about what just took place, but glad it's over with. Great effort from Erin Pearl, only 16 years of age, and her first experience at the Senior National Championships. Much more to come here at the Delta Center. Amber Corwin takes the ice next, trying to make a spot on the world team and stand on the podium. Back to Salt Lake City, Erin Pearl, only 16 years of age, next to Richard Callahan.
And this was a look at her first triple combination, a double toe, triple toe. What made that difficult? Because the triple was the second jump, so you have to keep your energy and your speed
and
up to be able to,
Erin Pearl
to complete the triple
merit
as the second jump.
5.1.
Mitch Moyer along
5.2.
With the two of them, 5.2. And now the first set of 5.3. Marks. Remember, this ladies' free skate were 2/3 of the overall 5.0. Score.
Now, you see, those marks are very low. She did a lot of good triple jumps there, but I think that they were looking for a little bit more than that, in the sense of the artistry of the, and that was what this mark tells you. Also, again, fairly low.
5.1.
A little bit higher, but 5. You're right. 5.1 to 5.4.
At this moment, she's still a little unfocused and unfinished. But underneath it all, she's got a very good athletic ability.
All right.
Presents a charming picture on the ice.
Amber Corwin and Scott Wendland, her coach, as she prepares to begin her free skate. So the State Farm U.S. Figure Skating Championships continue here in front of the largest crowd all week. The mobile update of the current standings, Michelle Kwan, Sarah Hughes, and Aaron Pearl.
Representing the All-Year Figure Skating Club in Culver City, California, here is Amber Corwin.
20 years of age from Hermosa Beach, California. She trains in Costa Mesa now, but in third place and trying to medal for the first time, she does control her own destiny.
The music
of the top three.
The music, Rhapsody in Blue.
Not only is she planning to do seven triples, she also performs them with a subtle sophistication.
That opening was very nice. Choreographically, it was beautifully gentle.
And this is her triple-triple combination. Triple toe, triple toe. Beautifully done.
Congratulations to her.
She just really takes her time on each jump. That's what you need to do. Another combination, triple flip, double toe combination. Triple flip, whoops, ended up to be a double.
From our angle, you could see that curve going into it changed, almost changed direction from the straight line. This double, triple, double axel.
To kind of get a second wind. She could put a lot more effort into these moves, stretch more, but she's resting because she has three more triples planned in this program toward the end. So this is a good way to pace herself through this 4-minute program.
Position not good enough. It needs more arch and stretch. It's flat out. It's a very fluid quality to her skating. Look at this triple loop. Now she slipped right off the edge of that and it landed up being a double.
Slow in the spinning. She's been so consistent in practice all week. I'm a little surprised that she's missed so many things so far.
Triple Lutz, she needs this. There was a long entrance into that. It took a long time to get her to move, and I think that hurt her with the rhythm of that jump.
You can be overly cautious sometimes.
That should have been a triple salchow. It was a double and double combination.
Nice final combination spin. Beautiful positions. disappointing.
She's a very stylish skater. And she takes everything so gently and slowly. She does not push it. She is not an in-your-face skater.
Her parents, Gail and Patrick, watching. An appreciative applause, but didn't bring anyone out of their seats. Disappointing for Amber Corwin, but in third place, trying to hold on to a medal. The 13-year-old Naomi Narayanan takes the ice next after this from our ABC stations. Highs and the lows of figure skating. Amber Corwin after a disappointing free skate here in the Delta Center.
Now, look at this. This was a terrific opening combination. A triple toe loop down and another one. And look at how easy it was, how gentle it was, and the position was just nice. But then later on, this is again the same move, but look closely at those feet, how deeply turned they are. She wraps it slightly, but not until the end.
Marks for here, they're straight Corwin and tight and down. Merit.
Well, she had seven triple jumps planned, but only completed three of those. She doubled four of the other jumps. So the first set of marks, not as high as she expected at all.
Well, those marks will just knock her out of any hope of pulling up, and it will be dangerous for even holding the third place.
Yeah, remember, she was in third place trying to medal and make the world team, and she's going to drop to fourth place now, right behind Aaron Pearl.
That's a disappointing moment for her.
And she can be such a beautiful skater.
There's Naomi, John Nix.
So she will take the ice as Michelle Kwan leads. We check the mobile current standing. Sarah Hughes and then 16-year-old Aaron Pearl holding on to that third spot. And Naomi Narayanan in fourth place after the short program. She's only 13. And I don't know how, but she knows how to play to an audience already.
Look at that face. Piano Concertos 2 and 3 by Rachmaninoff.
Well, she has a very clear vision of what she wants. Her dream is to win 2 Olympics. And she says, each day, each year, I'm getting closer and closer.
Why stop at 1?
Well, just look at this combination. See how it goes. First, a triple flip.
Look at the look on her face. That's what she fell on in the short program.
Look at that position right there. Very nice. And talk about laybacks. That's a sideways leaning spin. Now watch the lift that she gets. The stretch up and the lift. Good height.
And she pays attention to every detail of this program.
Triple loop, double footed at the end. That death drop is worthy of any athlete in this competition.
Had good lift, good stretch in it.
Not that she really feels a whole lot of pressure, but there really isn't any because Naomi cannot go to the World Championships. She's only 13 years of age. The rule states that you must be 15 by the previous July. Sarah Hughes can go because she medaled at the Junior Worlds.
This is her spiral into a triple toe, double toe combination.
That was a triple toe loop, double toe loop. Very good.
And this layback spin, she is an incredible position.
Look at the turnout. Look at the
and
back.
The arch.
The hip is behind her, not to the side.
Wonderful speed in it, too. She really listens to this music. She certainly knows how to perform it. Moves are so crisp and they're really quick, out of spark. Nice triple salchow.
She's also limber and flexible. Her spins have been clocked at 190 revolutions per minute. Believe that. Look at this.
Peggy, can you teach that? That appeal to the audience that is just there?
Not really. I mean, you either got it or you don't.
Now that was
nice.
Brilliant.
Triple toe.
It had such height to it. One other thing you should watch is her feet. Look at how she points them and stretches them. Don't tell me you can't point feet just because they're in skating boots.
And those are the details that do make the difference. And this is a very difficult move to do. It's almost like a layback spin position, but holding that control.
But that one could have been better. The knee, the leg was... Look at that split. There it is. There. Tell me who does a better one than that.
She knows she's done a great job.
And look at the energy and the swing to this. This is a faster turning camel than anybody has done. And watch this, sit spin and a lay back. Oh my heaven. Isn't this stupendous?
Turn on the spotlight. There's a 13-year-old that was born to be in it.
She was spectacular.
Connie and David, her parents, overwhelmed. They came to America from Korea.
Well, I'll tell you something. I think that the skating world has been waiting for this moment, and I think they're all breathing a huge sigh of relief to see such a startlingly delightful young lady take the stage.
In fourth place after the short program, how far can she move up? We'll wait and see. We'll check her marks when we come back. Michelle anxiously waiting. Here in Salt Lake City, a star was just created, Naomi Nari Nams.
She was absolutely precious. And this was a very strong opening combination, triple flip, double toe. And she was very happy to land this because she fell on that in the short program and hit her head. And this was another triple later on in the program. These falling leaves into a triple toe. Just real straight in the air, and she is happy as a clam.
And this comparison between the laybacks, I think, is interesting between Michelle and Naomi Nari Nam. Now, look here at the back and the stretch of the leg. The leg is the key to it. Right here, notice the height of this leg and the levelness to the ice. Michelle's comes down lower. The backs are equal. Very, very good, though, both of them.
John Nix tried to keep her away from practice because of the bump on her head that she sustained in the short program. She had none of it.
Now look at those marks. Oh, my. Oh, my.
Listen to the audience.
I'm not sure. Listen, it's perfectly all right. The important thing is she skated like she did, and she sparked this world. And it doesn't matter what the marks are, because now everybody will be forced into putting her into the position that she belongs in.
Presentation marks, and now the judges' placements all in second place, right behind Michelle Kwan. Remember, she's only 13, didn't medal at the Junior World Championships, didn't go. So she can't go to the World Championship, but...
This audience just loves her.
Look at the expressions. This is worth... Oh, what an evening.
Her mom and dad.
Her parents wiping away tears.
Well...
So the mobile current standings, Michelle Kwan holds on to the lead.
Representing Naomi the All-Year Figure Skating Club in Culver City, California.
In third
would you please
place,
welcome now, Angela Nikitinov.
And we'll hear a lot more from in the future, right behind Michelle Kwan. And here is Angela Nikitinov from San Pedro, California, in sixth place. Had a disappointing short program. She came in hoping to medal. Trying
music,
to move up.
The music by Paganini.
Well, Angela was the one to watch. I thought last year she was so talented, but her practices have been very, very poor this past week. And it would be such a shame to see this opportunity slip through her fingers.
One of the things you should notice is how strong and powerful and secure and steady she is.
opening a triple Lutz double toe combination. Very nice.
With a very good back.
Now another combination, triple flip, double toe. Good for her, just a triple flip, no double toe afterwards. She is a very good competitor. Makes me a little nervous when I see her having bad practices all week and then, you know, coming out and she pulls it off.
Positions in skating are really first rate. That's a lovely arch on her back. Beautiful turned out foot.
She finished fifth at Nationals a year ago and almost had a chance to compete at the World Championships when Nicole Bobek was injured. She would have been the first alternate, but she was in Bulgaria where her parents are from originally and could not make it there. And by the way, Nicole was supposed to be here, but is not competing because of illness.
Now that kind of loop mistake is not possible if one hopes to pull, but look at the position here. That is exquisite.
And she holds it long enough for us to see it and appreciate it. Always looks so calm in the competition. She doesn't look flustered or nervous at all. She takes her time on every move. Coming up is a triple salchow back inside edge takeoff. Nicely done, real straight in the air.
But she probably has the best control outside of Michelle Kwan of these triples of any of the skaters. Triples into doubles.
She had some wonderful moments in her routine, but a lot of flaws, too.
Well, she's a magnificent skater. When you get right down to it, her style, her control, the steadiness of her edging, the security of her jumps, I think she's a wonderful skater. I've thought so all along, and I hope she can overcome this temporary
yes.
difficulty.
She's a very natural jumper, too.
18-year-old Angela Nikodinov will have her marks and the final results when we come back. Back at the Delta Center, Angela Nikodinov along with her coach, Peter Oppegard.
And the judges' marks for
and
Angela
here was her triple Lutz double toe combination at the very beginning. Very solid, straight in the air. Looked very calm, very confident.
And now the marks. Let's see if she shakes up the top three and makes it to the podium. The first set for technical merit, 5.3 to 5.8.
And those were fairly high.
Remember, she finished fifth a year ago, was in sixth place after the short, and she jumps to third, Dick.
But this is interesting that these marks are relatively low.
but good enough to propel her all the way to third place. She's going to capture the bronze medal.
Oh my goodness,
that's wonderful.
And the interesting thing is that that knocks Sarah Hughes out of the top group.
So Angela Nikodinov, the final skater of the evening, is able to jump all the way from sixth to third. The final result, Michelle Kwan, her third U.S. ladies title. Naomi Nari Nam, who brought down the house, wins the silver medal. Then Angela Nikodinov, the bronze, and Sarah Hughes, the other 13-year-old, down in fourth place. A great finish for her, but she was in second for a while, then knocked out of second by Nam, and then all the way down to fourth. Now remember, normally the top three go to the World Championships as you look at the rest of the results, but Naomi Nari Nam can't go. She's too young. So it'll be interesting to see the international committee chooses to go to Helsinki.
Well, I'm sure they'll take Sarah Hughes on that one, along with Angela Nikodinov.
Maybe Kwan, Nikodinov, and Hughes. You're right. Leslie Visser in the Kiss and Cry.
Well, Terry, there are some familiar faces here and some new faces. It's quite a group. Congratulations to all of you. First to you, Sarah. You're only 13, but how'd you feel you did tonight?
I'm happy that I tried hard, and I'm happy that I did my triple-triple.
And for you, Angela, the short program was a little tough, but really came through in the long.
Yeah, I just wanted to come back and show them that I can do it, so I'm really happy.
You'll be the comeback kid. You certainly did. And you, my young friend, you might be the future that the skating world has been looking for. Can you talk about your very first? You completed the jump that you fell on the first time?
Yeah, I just had to block it out of my head, and I just had to go for it, thinking that I didn't do what I did Thursday.
Well, you started this competition with a headache, and you ended up with the silver medal. Can you talk about that swing?
Well, I've been, you know, training all year for this competition, and I felt that all the hard work has paid off.
You're a little bit too young to go to the world competition, but do you wish you could?
Well, yeah, of course I wish I could, but maybe next year.
Do you wish that they would amend the rules?
Yeah, I wish.
Well, we'll talk to them about that. And you, Michelle, you set the gold standard. Is the third one as meaningful as the first?
Well, it definitely is. And, you know, I came here not going to, like, thinking of winning. I just went out there to have fun and enjoy myself. And, you know, the crowd was right behind me. And when I did the triple-triple, I was like, can I get off? But I kept on going, and I felt really, really good.
Especially happy with the triple-triple. What happened on the Lutz?
I don't know.
You seem surprised.
I did. I thought I had it, and when I was on the ice, I was like, okay, what am I doing here? And so I just got back up and I said, okay, finish the program.
Do you feel like it would be in this arena that you can hang in for three more years of the intense scrutiny and the competition?
I sure hope so. At the end of my long program, I was thinking in my layback, I was like, geez, in a couple years, I'll be competing, hopefully, here at the same building in 2002.
Well, the United States has produced six Olympic female champions. We might be looking 3 years from now right here at this person right here. Back to you, Terry.
All right, Leslie, you guys have some fun in the Kiss and Cry, all right? Michelle Kwan, for the third time, the U.S. ladies champion. Naomi Nari Nam, a shooting star. We're going to see a lot from her. And Sarah Hughes, maybe back here in Salt Lake City in 3 years. We're coming back with a final word in a moment. Our coverage of these championships continues at 1:30 Eastern, 3 Pacific on ABC Sports. Next Sunday, the Chevrolet Skating Spectacular, the exhibition performances from all of the medalists. And we welcome you back one final time, along with Dick Button and Peggy Fleming. New things every year when you come to these championships. Huh? Two 13-year-olds that just dazzled everyone.
Something always exciting happens in this sport. It goes on from generation to generation. It's just very fascinating to see.
How about the top two, Peggy, in terms of what took place on the ice tonight? Michelle Kwan and...
They were just magical. Kwan is an incredible jumper. She completed six beautiful triple jumps and that one fall. And Naomi is a wonderful spinner. I think we can look forward to really enjoying her skating for many years.
Had a great time all week, guys.
And certainly in footwork and artistry, you got to hand it to
her. For our entire ABC crew, Peggy Fleming, Dick Button, Leslie Visser, and all of us here, thank you for watching. A great week in Salt Lake City. Good night, everyone.